Yo, what's going on, everybody? Shri Kanase here. So how to make $10,000 in sales this coming Black Friday. Now, I know this number seems like a huge stretch for some of you, and you may be just thinking, Shri, this is a clickbait video. There's no way that I'm going to be making $10,000 in a single day, specifically on Black Friday. Trust me, this number is very, very achievable come Black Friday and the Cyber Monday weekend. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys two stages to preparing for Black Friday so that you actually hit this number. Now, one big thing you want to understand is hitting this number is no big deal. It's actually preparing to hit this number that's going to take most of the time. And there are two stages like I'm going to be showing you guys in this video, which are involved in reaching this amount of sales in a single day. But without wasting any more time, let's just jump right into the specific stages. Before we talk about the specific stages, let's try to understand why this number is so achievable for literally everybody, as long as you have a Shopify store and a proven product or several products on your store. People in the world have become accustomed to the idea that Black Friday, Cyber Monday equals massive discounts on all types of products. And this has kind of gotten inside their head into their buying psychology. And this is the biggest contributing factor towards this specific day. Especially on Black Friday, it is known to be the biggest sale in the entire year, specifically for electronics, but other people that are running other types of stores in other niches, or just like you and me, Shopify stores, can take advantage of this. So basically what we are planning to do in order to hit this amount is to make use of the buying psychology that on this specific day on Black Friday, they're bound to get huge discounts. So exactly what should you be doing and how should you be starting? Well, in the first stage, let's start off by talking about the emails, because emails play a huge part in achieving these kinds of numbers when it comes to Black Friday. And if you haven't ever even used emails, this is the best time to start using emails and really get your things together. So with emails, the first thing you want to actually start doing right away, if you haven't already done this, is basically start preparing emails to get sent 1 to 3 weeks prior to the actual sale. So Black Friday is, I think, around November 29th of this upcoming month. So that means you still have some time left to prepare for this holiday. It may not be a lot, but there's still some time left. So starting specifically the first to the second week of November, which is basically here, what you want to do is you want to start sending sale and brand awareness or website awareness emails. And in this case, the sale is basically a pre-sale, basically telling your customers that there is going to be this huge sale on your website coming up come Black Friday. And for this, what I like to do is I like to use a custom landing page so that I can grab everybody's emails. And I want to go ahead and show you guys one of the custom landing pages which I've personally made specifically for this upcoming event. And this landing page is not fully prepared yet, but this is basically just an example to show you guys how it would work. So this is my landing page, and I've made this through the email app that I use, which is called MailerLite. Now, if you guys want to use MailerLite for your emails, I'll leave a link for you guys down below. It will be an affiliate link, but MailerLite basically lets you create custom landing pages just like these ones. And our main goal for the Black Friday Cyber Monday event is to create a very, very simple and straightforward custom landing page just so that we can get their email. Now, as you can see, there's nothing fancy or anything interesting in my specific landing page. The people that land on this page is that they can enter their email to get notified the moment our biggest Black Friday sale launches. And this specific section is so that I can get their email address. And below that, we have the specific sale timer going on right now, which says 28 days. And this is the real timer, meaning Black Friday is literally 28 days away. What I'm going to do for the first 1 to 3 weeks of November is basically start sending traffic to this landing page. I can do this via running some Facebook ads, which I'll be going over very soon, or I can simply send emails to people who have already registered to my email list to ask them to enter their email so that they can get notified the moment our Black Friday sale launches. And the cool thing about MailerLite is all of the emails entered here can be saved to a separate list. So you can specifically create email flows that get sent directly to this email list that people registered for the landing page. So this is something very interesting that you can do as well. So this is what I plan to do as well to make about $10,000 in sales. But when it comes to emails in stage one, our main goal is to capture their emails so that we can start sending them these pre-sale offers and brand or website awareness emails. But the second thing has to do with your website itself. So when it comes to Black Friday, what you want to do from now on, the moment you watch this video, is first of all, start changing the colors, the images on your website, the overall theme, banner, whatever you can to mention the Black Friday Cyber Monday sale and match the specific Black Friday Cyber Monday overall theme of colors. So the more you match the specific event's colors, the better it will be for you. And that's why my custom landing page had a little bit of black on the as the background, simply because that matches the theme of Black Friday really well. But in addition to that, you want to start displaying some type of discounts that will be coming up come Black Friday. So these are things that you can say is something like upcoming Black Friday sale up to 67% off, or upcoming Black Friday sale up to 57% off. One big tip I want to give you guys is use odd numbers. They work the best. So instead of doing 52% off, do 53% off. And this is just a psychological thing where odd numbers just work better than even numbers. So this is something that you want to do even when it comes to the sales. You want to basically start mentioning these upcoming sales as much as you can on your entire website. So people are kind of becoming aware. They're kind of looking forward to the sale. One big thing I want to say is if people are anticipating a sale, they're looking forward to a sale, you're going to crush it on Black Friday rather than just coming up directly on Black Friday randomly and saying, hey, we have a sale going on. If you build up this momentum, if you build up this wanting to participate in your Black Friday sale, people will be more likely to participate in it and you will make much more money on Black Friday. But moving on to our third thing, which is using timers for Black Friday. And I like to start using timers beforehand, as you guys saw on my landing page for emails. Basically, what I like to do is come Black Friday, I like to have a main timer at the very top of the website with the end time set at the beginning of Black Friday. And to show you guys exactly what I mean by having a main timer at the very top of the website, I have an example website pulled up for you guys, and this website is called alphaaccessories.co. It is actually a bracelet and fashion-based store. But if we look at the very top, as you can see, there's a timer going on at the very top of the page, which says, hurry, distant bracelets, 65% off, sale ends in 16 minutes and 31 seconds. Hurry, they're almost sold out. So this is generally what you want to be doing pre-Black Friday, but instead of having this timer end in 16 minutes, what you can do is have this specific timer set to 29 days or how many ever days are left for Black Friday to arrive. And again, the main reason why we're doing this is so that we can basically put a little bit of curiosity inside our customer's mind that there is some big kind of sale coming up on our website, and people actually will start looking forward to this sale, especially if you do all of the three things I've mentioned so far. But if you combine this with the fourth thing, you're gonna absolutely crush it this upcoming Black Friday and hit the goal of $10,000 in sales, and that is involving advertisement. So what should you exactly be doing when it comes to ads for Black Friday Cyber Monday? The first thing I recommend that you start doing right away from this point is test creatives via the website conversions optimized campaigns, and these should be optimized for view content. Basically, you want to be testing the ad copy text along with the video or image ads, if possible, if you have some kind of custom video or image ad made that is directly related to Black Friday. If not, just use your main product's image, whatever is selling for you, and just change the ad copy text to match something related to Black Friday. And again, these things should be geared mostly towards the Black Friday Cyber Monday sale. But along with that, what you want to be doing is once you run this specific campaign, maybe 5 ad sets directed towards your main winning audiences, with 3 different ad copies per ad set, you want to run post engagement campaigns for the winners that you find in this first campaign. Because the main reason why I'm asking you to do this is so that basically you'll have a lot of engagement built up for these winning ad copies, which then you can use come Black Friday. And that's something I'm going to be talking about in stage 2 at the end. But in stage 1, we're basically preparing for Black Friday Cyber Monday events. And with these winning ad copies, we're going to be running them consistently on that specific given day to really hit this specific number of 10,000. But something that you can do related to the specific ad copies is basically start preparing a percent off sale for Black Friday. And again, your ad copies can mention this sale, maybe it can be 67% off, 69% off, but make sure to insert a specific amount inside your ad copy. Along with that, make sure to mention that this is a Black Friday sale that's coming up. These two are some of the biggest things that you can do in order to find success come Black Friday, because people have to know that whatever sale you currently have going on is for Black Friday and nothing else. So again, it's kind of hitting the customer psychology where if they see Black Friday or a specific percent off sale mentioned, they're much more likely to trust it and much more likely to engage with your ad copies. But this is exactly what you should be doing in the first 1 to 3 weeks of November, basically 1 to 3 weeks prior to the actual event. So what should you do come the actual event? And how should you be preparing for that specific weekend, where is the Black Friday, Cyber Monday? So the first thing, again, we'll start by talking about the emails. What should you be doing regarding the emails? The first thing you want to actually do, and this is something you should start planning for right now, is you want to send 4 emails on Black Friday. The first email will be sent at 12 a.m. right when it hits Black Friday time, telling the customers that the sale officially has started and giving customers some kind of incentive to buy right now. It could be a specific coupon in addition to the Black Friday sale, or it could be a specific timer that you have put inside the email saying this Black Friday sale is going to last for only 12 hours or something like that. The second email should be sent at 6 a.m. in the morning of Black Friday. And again, this should go over the first email that you sent regarding the specific sale that's going on and any type of coupon or urgent, to really make it seem much, much more urgent. The third email should be sent at 12 p.m. And at this point, you want to mention that half of the day has gone, meaning there's only half day left to really purchase the products that the customers may want. And the final email, which is sent at 6 p.m. on Black Friday, to remind them that there's only a few items left in stock because a lot of the items have already been sold out. So this is the last email that should be sent on Black Friday. But along with this, you should be planning 2 more emails per day on Saturday and Sunday following the Black Friday, because very soon you'll be hitting Cyber Monday. So these 2 emails per day should be sent on Saturday and Sunday, reminding the customers that on the Black Friday sale, the sale was really big and a lot of customers bought a lot of things from you. But there may be some people who did not get a chance to purchase from you, and this is where you try to get those people as well. Basically, send them 2 emails per day on these 2 given days and just let them know that you have restocked for Cyber Monday, and this is really the last chance for these customers to get the products that they wanted from your store at a discount. And again, our main goal is to basically build up a little bit of more momentum so people can actually really start anticipating for the Cyber Monday sale as well, in case they miss the Black Friday sale. And what you'll notice is that a lot of people that actually shopped on Black Friday will also come back to shop on Cyber Monday. So this is kind of a double win-win situation for you. But come Cyber Monday, what should you be doing exactly? Well, you should be sending 3 emails on Cyber Monday instead of 4. And on Cyber Monday, you want to send the first email at 6 a.m., second one at 12 p.m., and third one at 6 p.m. Again, the strategy will be the exact same. Basically, build up scarcity for Cyber Monday. Let people know that the sale is going on currently, but items are running really fast out of stock, and you can't guarantee that they will remain in stock for the customers. So again, through these emails, our main goal is to build up that scarcity inside of the customer's head so that they actually do purchase something from you. But along with this, when it comes to the specific website, what you should be doing is basically changing the timer to end now on Cyber Monday. So in the text, you should be mentioning something related to Cyber Monday, saying how the sale will end on Cyber Monday, and the timer should showcase that exactly. Along with that, you should be changing the overall theme of your website and the color scheme to match that of Cyber Monday. And we want to be aligned with the specific event as much as we can. And this also relates to the specific colors that you use on your website, along with the overall theme. So this is one important step you don't want to forget to do. Along with this, you want to include some scarcity in the descriptions and mention the Black Friday and the Cyber Monday sale. So these changes apply to Black Friday as well, not just Cyber Monday, but mention the Black Friday sale or the Cyber Monday sale in the descriptions. Because when everything is specifically aligned on your website, it brings out this more professional look that really makes people want to trust you much more and really buy from your website. So again, doing all of these things will definitely help you with that. But moving on to our final thing, and that's actually the advertisements. When it comes to ads for Black Friday, Cyber Monday, you want to take your ads game to the next level. Instead of just maybe launching 5 or 10 ad sets, here is when you want to go all in. And I recommend that you start out with 5 CBOs in the beginning, basically at the start of Black Friday, using all of the ad copies that were winners in the first stage. That's why we tested the ad copies in stage number 1, because we wanted to use that for the ads in stage number 2. So I recommend that you run 5 CBOs starting on Black Friday. You can set the budget to whatever you like. I recommend that you set it at a budget of $10 to $20 per ad set. Meaning, if you have 5 ad sets per CBO, you can either set the budget at $50 a day to $100 a day. And from there, we can scale based on the types of results we get. Basically, what we want to be doing is we want to be testing our top audiences inside these CBOs. And if you don't have any top audiences yet, Don't worry, what you want to do is take this time that you have right now to test different types of audiences. It could be lookalikes or interests, and basically find those top audiences which you can then use for the CBOs. But inside these five CBOs, you should have specific winning audiences, and you want to be using the main winning creatives you found in stage number one. But when it comes to scaling these specific CBOs, I like to call this the rapid scaling method. Basically, what we're doing is we're increasing the budget by 100% every 3 to 5 hours, depending on the performance. So let's say, for example, you start these CBOs at 12 a.m. and after about 3 to 5 hours, maybe 6, when you wake up in 6 a.m. in the morning, you notice that out of these 5 CBOs, 3 CBOs are bringing you back a 5x return on ad spend. What you want to do then is, if you had the budget set at $100 a day for each of these CBOs, you want to up that budget to $200 per day for those CBOs with the 4x or 5x return on ad spend. And we want to do this every 3 to 5 hours from 6 a.m. all the way till 12 a.m. at night. During Black Friday and Cyber Monday, you're going to be looking at your ads more often because this is the time to really make that money and those sales come in. So this is exactly how you're going to be scaling after you launch your 5 specific CBOs. And if your first 5 CBOs launched don't work well, don't worry, just relaunch them with new interests or audiences. And this will really guarantee that you make the best bang out of your buck come Black Friday and Cyber Monday. But this is the exact strategy as to how you can be making roughly $10,000 in sales or more come this Black Friday. Again, there are 2 stages to this and there's a lot of work, but I guarantee you that if you put in the work and if you really do this step by step and watch this video over and over again, if you didn't understand any of it, you're gonna really crush it this Black Friday. But if you found any type of value in this video, make sure to smash that like button down below and subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys next time.